Hi, good day to everyone. I am here once again for the part 2 of our lesson 5, which is preparing stocks, sauces, and soups. Here are our learning targets for today. Number 1, I can classify various types of sauces. Number 2, I can explain the methods of preparing sauces. Number 3, I can explain the methods of reheating stocks, sauces, and soups.
Sauce is a term used in cookery to describe a wide range of flavored liquids that are served as part of the meal or dish. The addition of a sauce to a dish can be used to transform the overall presentation of a dish by adding flavor, moisture, richness, and visual appeal. Sauces come in a variety of different styles and consistencies. They can be thick or thin, rich and creamy, or light and delicate. Depending on the purpose, sauces can be strongly flavored, hot and spicy, or even sweet to be served with a dessert. The way in which the sauce is presented will depend very much on the dish being served. The sauce may be served partially masked over the food, served under the food, or served in a separate dish. Principles of preparing sauces. Number 1. Take note that most sauces are based on the principle of reduction of liquids. Sauces are the melding of ingredients including stocks, wine, aromatics, herbs, and dairy into a harmonious taste. Most small sauces are based on the principle of reduction. That means cooking down various liquids with aromatics, wine, and herbs to meld, concentrate, and balance the flavor and consistency. This method is used to create a simple sauce by deglazing the pan from a roast and enhancing its flavor with aromatic vegetables, stock, and seasoning. A pan sauce is created in a similar fashion when a sautéed protein produces caramelized bits that cling to the pan, along with the juices that are rendered from the cooked items, whether they are meat, poultry, or fish. The sauce is completed with a reduction of wine and aromatics and finished with whole butter or cream. Number 2. Other sauces are made through emulsions of fats or through pureeing. Culinary emulsion refers to combining fat and liquid. An emulsion is a mixture of two liquids that don't fully combine. An emulsion may look like a single liquid, but it's made up of particles of one liquid distributed throughout another liquid. In the example shown, this is an emulsion of oil and eggs, which makes mayonnaise. Puree is a way to turn solid foods into a liquid with a texture similar to pudding. Puree is a food that has been ground or crushed into a thick liquid. The five grande sauces or the mother sauces includes espagnol, bechamel, velouté, hollandaise, and tomato sauce. These sauces incorporate aromatics including onions, celery, and carrots, depending on the sauce, that are sautéed to either a translucent stage or browned further for color and flavor. Secondary sauces are derived from mother sauces that includes Allemande, Mornay, Demi-glace, etc. Secondary sauces are also called derivatives. These are sauces created by adding additional component to the mother sauces. Types of sauces. Bechamel sauce. It is also known as a cream sauce or a white sauce. This mother sauce is made by thickening milk with a white roux, seasonings, and flavorings. Hollandaise sauce. It is made from emulsified egg yolks, clarified butter, seasonings, and lemon juice. Espanol sauce. It is made from thickened brown stock. Espanol sauce, which is French for Spanish sauce, also contains some type of tomato product. In general, this type of sauce has few added seasonings. Tomato sauce is made by simmering a tomato product with flavorings, seasonings, and stock or another liquid. Although basic tomato sauce is made with vegetables only, some variations add meat. Tomato sauce is a very versatile sauce. Velouté sauce. It is also known as blanc sauce. It is made by thickening a light-colored stock with a light-colored roux. This sauce is named after the type of stock it contains. Other sauces. From the five basic mother sauces come hundreds of different compound sauces. Not all sauces, however, come from these mother sauces. Some sauces are made from a puree of fruits or vegetables. Other sauces are just made from meat juices or butter. Salsa. It is a combination of raw vegetables or fruits, spices, onions, and chilies. They can be used for more than dipping vegetables or chips. Salsas can also be used as sauces for potatoes, poultry, meat, or fish entrees. Relishes. These are another type of sauce often made with fruits or vegetables. This sauce may be used as a condiment or sauce for meat, poultry, and fish. The sauce may be cooked or pickled, meaning preserved in a seasoned solution of vinegar or brine. Relishes may be sweet, savory, or spicy. They also vary in texture from smooth to chunky. Gravy. This is a type of sauce made from meat or poultry juices. Liquids such as milk, cream, or broth, and a thickening agent such as roux. Compound butters. You can make a compound butter by adding seasonings to soften butter. Sometimes, a compound butter is placed on top of a piece of fish or meat just before serving it. As the butter melts, it flavors the food. It also makes an elegant presentation. Other examples of sauces are independent sauces that includes applesauce, cocktail sauce, and sweet and sour sauce. Sauce ingredients. Sauces are made of liquid ingredients, thickening agents, seasonings, and flavorings. Classic sauces rely on combinations of a few basic ingredients. Liquid ingredients. The liquid ingredient in most sauces serves as the base or body. You will commonly use some type of stock as the base for a sauce. You may use white stock made from chicken, veal, or fish. Other sauces call for brown stock. Vinegar or tomato products may be added to sauces for acidity. Sometimes, milk is also used as a base. Clarified or drawn butter is another liquid ingredient in sauces. Thickening agents. A major difference between stocks and sauces is that a sauce must be thickened. Most thickening agents are forms of starch. Starch granules will absorb moisture when placed in a liquid, a process called gelatinization. Most sauces use this process in thickening. Seasonings and flavorings can also be used to enhance the flavors of a dish. Salt, pepper, mustard, vinegar, spices, and herbs can all change the flavor of a sauce. The liquid ingredients may make up the basic flavor of most sauces, but the seasonings and flavorings you include will add the finishing touches. Methods of preparing sauces. Number 1. Roux method. Roux method is the most commonly used thickening agent. It is a mixture of lard and fat cooked together to form a paste. Roux ingredients includes fats like clarified butter, margarine, animal fats, vegetable oil, and shortening. Starch includes flour and other types of starches. Number 2. Blended method. In blended method, the starch is blended with the liquid and no fat is added. A small amount of the liquid is blended with the corn flour. The remaining liquid is heated. The liquid is poured onto the corn flour, stirring carefully. The sauce is returned to the pan and brought back to the boil. Number 3. All-in-one method. In all-in-one method, all of the ingredients are placed in a saucepan and brought to a boil with continuous stirring to prevent the sauce from having lumps. Characteristics of good sauce. A good sauce must have no lumps, a flavor that is not floury or pasty, sticks to the back of the spoon, and will not break apart when it cooks down. Methods of storing and reheating stocks, sauces, and soups. For the stocks, always cool stock before you store it. Stock can be stored for several days in a refrigerator. Boil for at least 2 minutes when reheating and never reheat after reboiling. Soups. If you want to store thick soup, cool and refrigerate the soup before adding the milk or cream. Soups will continue to thicken as you reheat them. Stir the mixture often. Taste the soup before serving and adjust the seasonings if needed. Sauces. If a sauce must be stored, cover the sauce with oiled parchment paper before storing. Sauces should be labeled, dated, and keep refrigerated. Place them on plastic containers with tight lids, and reheat in a double boiler and stir well. CSMA Values Integration.
For CSMA Values Integration, we have learned that stocks form the foundation of sauces and soups. The quality of sauces and soups depends on the stocks that are used as their base. The preparation of stocks, sauces, and soups help us to realize the principle of what we reap is what we sow. All the good things that we do in life will be reciprocated with good things. That's it for today, and have a nice day. Bye!